If you have an email marketing list, you probably want to try and keep it clean, but sometimes people just stop engaging with the stuff that you're sending out. So what do? Well, today I'm going to show you how you can automatically remove inactive subscribers from your list. So let's hop right in. Hey, I'm Rodger with RodgerMelissa.com, and today I'm going to be doing this in ActiveCampaign. Now, if you're not currently an ActiveCampaign user, there is a link in the description below where you can go get your own free trial. Also, be sure to stay to the end because as a bonus, I'm going to give you some recommendations on what to do with those inactive subscribers once you've identified them. All right, so here we are in ActiveCampaign and I've navigated to the automation section. The first thing I'm going to do is click on Create an Automation. Now, we could absolutely do this from scratch, but good news is ActiveCampaign actually already has some pre-built automations to do exactly what we're looking to do. If you scroll down here, you see part one engagement tagging, part two engagement tagging. In order to accomplish this, you actually need two short automations that work together, and I'll explain to you how they do that. The first thing we're gonna do is click on this one here. See, if I click on Read More, this says import part one of this two-part automation first. Both automations must be imported for them to work. Okay, let's start with this one. Continue. You'll see that ActiveCampaign has already built out this automation and it's very short. And let me kind of describe to you what it's going to do. This automation is going to determine what tags a contact gets based on how long it's been since they've engaged with any of our stuff. So if you look at this from top to bottom, at the top, we're going to have people that have just engaged with our stuff. And as we go down and time goes on, we're going to add other tags that let us know that they've not been engaging with our stuff. The first thing we're going to do is tag them with a tag called engaged. There are three main tags we're going to apply: engaged, disengaged, and inactive throughout this automation. We've also got one here called recent activity that kind of goes with engaged, so we can see those people that have actually done something recently within the last week. So following this down, somebody opens an email. The first thing that happens is we tag them engaged. We're also going to tag them recent activity. If by chance they had been in this automation before and they had waited a long time before they engaged with something, they might have already been tagged with disengaged or inactive. So we want to remove the tag disengaged if it happens to be there and remove the tag inactive if it happens to be there. If they're not there, if this is a brand new contact, it doesn't do anything. And by the way, all of these things that we're talking about, if I click on the plus icon, they're all found within here. I can click on a wait time. I can click on add a tag, remove tag. I can also go over here and search for things like wait, and I can drag them in here to a plus sign to add them, right? But I'm not gonna do that for now. Just to let you know that you could build this by yourself. We're gonna put them in a wait stage for 7 days. Now that means that if they've been in there for 7 days and they still have not again engaged with our stuff, we're going to remove the tag recent activity, because they haven't engaged in at least a week. Then we're gonna put them in another wait state. We're gonna wait for 21 more days. If they're still in this automation after 7 days, then another 21 days, and remember this is incremental, so this is like 28 days, 4 weeks, we now don't wanna call them engaged anymore. We're actually gonna add the tag disengaged and remove the tag engaged. Then we're going to wait for 30 days. So by this point in time, we've waited the initial 7 days, another 21 days, and now we're waiting for 30 days. If they still have not engaged with the stuff we're sending out in 60 days by now, we're actually going to tag them as inactive and remove the tag disengaged. So you see at each milestone, we removed the tag that was there and added the next tag. And that's all this automation does. And we're going to talk about what to do with them once they reach this inactive phase in a few minutes. And lastly, all of these are editable. If you want to change the number of days you wait before you remove the tag recent activity, or you want to change the number of days you wait before you define someone as disengaged, or the number of days you wait before you tag them as inactive, these are all editable. I could say wait for 60 days, save, and now that's changed. All right, let's go back to our automations and we're now going to create part two of engagement tagging. Choose part two, choose continue. Now this one has a short setup wizard that is going to walk us through in order to set this up properly. I'm going to click get started. The first thing it's going to ask us, because one of the triggers this automation already has defined in it, is if someone visits a page on our website. So it's asking you, well, what website is that? What is your domain? And do you care what page they interact with in order to get put into this automation? So I'm just going to choose rodgermelissa.com, and I could type in a specific page here, but I don't care. If they go to my website and go to any page, we can use this wildcard to represent any page on my domain. So I'm going to click on next. We also need to tell it which automation do we want it to work with. So this happens to be an exit and automation step, which you don't need to know what that is right now. But remember, this one's going to work right alongside part one. This is part two. So we need to go find part one. And here it is, part one engagement tagging. Next. And it's going to ask you again, this is for the intern automation step. What's the other automation that we got to work with? I could just type in part one here. I find it, click apply, and click done. Okay. So this is the extent of this automation. That's all it is. Now let's see what it's doing. There are currently three triggers, and these are or conditions. So if any one of these three exists, then this automation will be triggered and a contact will be put into this automation. It's if the contact reads any email that we send, opens an email, right? If they click a link in any email that we send, or if they visit any page on my website, which we just defined a minute ago. Now you're gonna have to have site tracking set up to do this, and we'll do another video on site tracking. But let's pretend like I didn't want that one. I can just delete that if I want to. And now we just have these two. Or I could add another condition that brings them in here, something that defines how they're engaging with me. Once they get into this automation, there's only two things that are happening. The first thing that's going to happen, it says, if the contact is currently in that other automation that we just did, part one engagement tagging, I want you to pull them out of there, and then I want you to immediately put them right back in. So in essence, what this is doing is pulling them out of that automation wherever they are and putting them back at the top. They are restarting the timer for the tags. So exit part one engagement tagging, enter part one engagement tagging, and end this automation. So going back to the other one, here's part one engagement tagging. Knowing what part two does, somebody opens an email, they go into that automation. At first, it's going to look to see if they're in this automation, they're going to take them out, and then they're going to put them right back in here at the top. Because they engage with our email, now they're tagged engaged again. They're tagged as recent activity. If they were disengaged, we're going to remove that. If they were inactive, we're going to remove that. We're going to wait for 7 days, so on and so forth. Until the point in time where they open another one of our emails, we're going to take them out, put them back in at the top again. Now let's talk about what to do when we identify them as inactive. So far, all we've done is added a tag that identifies them as inactive. So we have choices here. We can simply leave them as inactive, and we can manually go back every now and then, look at the contacts that are tagged as inactive, and decide whether or not we want to unsubscribe them. What I would suggest you do is go ahead and add an action here for all inactive subscribers. Let's see, conditions, contacts, unsubscribe from my list. So now when a contact goes inactive, we're automatically going to unsubscribe them from our list. Easy. Now the last thing we've got to do to make this complete in ActiveCampaign is you just need to go activate our automation. So let's go back to automations. And we're going to, here on part one and part two, I'm going to click on the down arrow and click make active. And then engagement tagging, click make active. So now as a bonus, let's talk about, some people might say, well, if I've unsubscribed them from my list, then I really don't even want them in my ActiveCampaign account anymore. Well, I would recommend that this really depends on how you obtain your contacts, what kind of business you're in. But I will tell you that having a contact in your database, but not on a list, doesn't really hurt anything. So in ActiveCampaign, you're not paying for anyone unless they're actually subscribed to a list. So a contact that is in here, but not on a list, does not count towards your number that you have to pay for your contact limits based on your subscription to ActiveCampaign. So they don't hurt anything. Plus, if you are selling any product, if you are tagging anyone as customer and the product that they bought, or if you're tagging anyone that downloads a lead magnet, if you ever want to go back and look at those metrics on how many people have downloaded your lead magnet, if you delete the contact, you're also going to be deleting that tag. So you're going to lose sight of that information. So my recommendation is to just leave them in there and unsubscribe them from your list, as we're doing here, automatically, and you're good. And lastly, just to give you a sneak peek, we're going to do a video on this. And when we post it, I'll actually put a card up in the upper right-hand corner so you can watch that video. You can send them, before you unsubscribe them, into a re-engagement series, which basically gives them one more chance to engage with you before you unsubscribe them. Now remember, if you're not currently an ActiveCampaign user and you want to try it out, go to the link in the description below and get your own free trial account. And if you receive some value, go ahead and subscribe. And these videos over here, YouTube picked them out just for you. Until next time, take care.